It's no surprise that GTA Online and the Fast and Furious movies are very similar. Rockstar has definitely taken a bunch of ideas from the Fast movies and implemented them as cars, of course, in GTA Online. And in this video, actually, I wanted to go over an updated version of the best Fast and Furious cars in GTA Online. This is a 2021 updated version, and I really just wanted to do this because the new movie, the new Fast and Furious movie, just came out. And if you are one to want to make a Fast and Furious garage in GTA Online, hopefully this video does help you out. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and hop in. These are in no particular order of car, of course, but this first vehicle, I mean, it's Brian's Nissan Skyline. This is, of course, from Too Fast, Too Furious. This is probably the most popular vehicle in GTA Online from Fast and the Furious movies. Very simple to make. I'm not going to go into the detail of how you make all of these cars. You can get the gist of it from the gameplay, but this for sure is something you're going to want to add to your collection. This is the LG Retro Custom. So if you do want to purchase it, then there's the vehicle. Next up is another one that just everyone knows what this is. This is Han's Mazda RX-7 from, of course, Tokyo Drift. This is the Banshee 900R. You can find this. I think you have to convert the regular Banshee at Benny's, but it does have its own livery, which of course makes it like Han's vehicle from the movie. And one thing I will just say, these aren't going to be like 100% shot for shot remake of the Fast and Furious cars, but these are definitely the best you're going to get. The third one is actually one that is a relatively newer one. At least this car was relatively new in GTA Online. This is the Impante Beater Dukes. And of course, this is Dom's 1970 Dodge Charger from The Fast and the Furious. You have the black car with the chrome outline. And the reason you want to use the Impante Beater Dukes, the newer version of the Dukes vehicle, is because it actually has a working belt, as you can see on the front there. So this is definitely a car you need to have in your Fast and Furious garage. Now, another very, very popular one is the LG Retro Custom. Again, this one is Brian's blue Skyline from the Fast, or I think it's just called Fast and Furious. The names are very confusing, I will say. But this is another very, very popular one. It is a very simple one to make. I mean, you just need the blue sort of paint job here with the spoiler and then similar looking rims. But this is one that is another, I think, must have in your Fast and Furious garage. Now, I believe this fifth one is actually another relatively newer vehicle to GTA Online. This one is the Dubachi Rapid GT Classic, you can see on the bottom right. And this is actually the Ford Mustang from the Tokyo Drift movie. You have this nice dark green paint job on it with, of course, the white livery down the middle. So this is actually one that isn't as popular. So if you want to have a different car from the Fast and Furious movies that definitely still stands out, this is more than likely going to be one of the better ones for that. The sixth vehicle, of course, streets closed, pizza boy, find another way home. This is from the first Fast and the Furious movies. And this one is the LG Retro Custom. Again, Rockstar actually put in a livery that is pretty identical to the one from the movie. So if you put on that livery with the yellow paint job, then you have the pizza boy car from that first movie. So this is another one that is just a very well-known one, and it's probably something you're going to want in your Fast and Furious garage. Here we have, I think the seventh one, a slot or a vehicle that is another lesser-known one or lesser seen one, at least in GTA Online. This one is the Penumbra FF. I think this is another relatively newer vehicle Rockstar's added, but this is Brian's 1995 Mitsubishi Eclipse from that first Fast and Furious movie. So if you want to stand out, showcase your knowledge of the film, then definitely put this one in your garage. Moving us to some of the newer movies, we have Letty's C2 Corvette from The Fate of the Furious. Again, the names are weird. But this one is a relatively easy one to make. It's the Cockette, the Inveturo Cockette Classic. It's a sports classic vehicle. And you just put the beautiful red paint job on with some black rims, and then you have Letty's Corvette from the movie. Another one from that same movie, The Fate of the Furious, we have Dom's 1968 Dodge Charger Daytona. And it's another very simple one to make. This one is the Impante Phoenix in GTA Online. It's a muscle car. Put that red paint job. I think this red paint job may be a little bit too bright. You might have to at least play with the paint jobs slightly more if you're doing this on your own. Like I said, these aren't 100% remakes, but this is Dom's Charger Daytona from The Fate of the Furious. Another car from that same movie, we have Letty's Rally Fighter. So this one is another cool one. It's a more niche one. It's obviously not a street racer or anything, but this one is the Coil Brawler. It's an off-road vehicle. I think in the movie there's like a red outline on the car. Unfortunately, Rockstar didn't provide that for this particular vehicle, but we just have like a silver paint job on it with some black rims. I think those are actually the stock rims. And then the rest, I think we put the bar up on the front. But yeah, definitely if you want to switch it up, instead of having, you know, the street racer cars, definitely throw this one in your garage. Here we have another lesser known one. This one is Brian's 1970 Ford Escort from Fast and the Furious 6. I don't know if that movie had a specific name or not, but this one is another one that is a lesser seen one. You have the bright blue paint job, the white livery down the middle, the golden-esque rims, and it's another one that you can just throw in your garage if you want to fill it up with a car from the movies. I don't even know what number we're on, but here we have Sean's 2006 Mitsubishi Lancer Evo from the movie Tokyo Drift. Now, this one unfortunately isn't as close as some of the other ones. This one is definitely one that you're going to have to use some imagination to make it, you know, look like the one in the game or in the movie. But it is, of course, the Sultan RS with the black little box livery. It is red, and we have, I believe, a tuner rim on it. But this one is one of the other cars from that Tokyo Drift movie. And if you wanted a classier vehicle, well, then we move to Deckard Shaw's Jaguar F-Type from The Fate of the Furious. This one is a relatively easy one to make. There's not a whole lot to it. You need a dark green paint job here on the Ocelot Lynx. So this one definitely is your more classier one. It's not crazy with liveries or anything. The downside, I guess, of that is people may not notice it's actually from Fast and the Furious. So maybe that's something for just you to know. And then here we have Brian's 10-second car. Now this one is the LG... this one actually is the Dinka Jester Classic. And this livery is actually called 10-second car. So Rockstar definitely were modeling this off of the Fast and Furious version. But this is another very popular Fast and Furious car that you can find in GTA Online. And then, of course, if you want to round out your garage, we have some of the vehicles that we're only using a couple of scenes. We have the Insurgent here. This, of course, was Agent Hobbs' vehicle, I believe, from Fast 5. So this is a vehicle you can throw in your garage. We also have the Wastelander here. I don't think you can customize this in GTA Online, but this one was from the scene in Fast 5, I think, where they're trying to steal the car off the train. So this is another one you can throw in your garage. Well, actually, I don't think you can put this in any garage. I believe you do unfortunately have to put this in the import and export, like vehicle warehouse garage, but either way, it's another one that's sort of from the movies. And then the one we'll end on is the ramp buggy. This one is from Fast and Furious 6, and it's another one that they use in a couple of scenes. So that's gonna do it for the list. That's about 15 or so of the probably most popular Fast and the Furious cars in GTA Online. Of course, there are many, many, many more cars from those movies that you can find in GTA Online. And if you guys want, I can maybe make a part 2 of this video Let me know in the comments section. Maybe this list will have to be updated once the summer update does release in about a month or so, because it does sound like it's going to be a tuner style of an update. So maybe Rockstar are implementing even more cars from the Fast movies in GTA Online. We'll have to wait and see though. But until then, thank you guys for watching. Please drop the video like if you did enjoy. Subscribe for more GTA content. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.